Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can use the new game controls. This is a new feature available on Spline now, and it's very cool because now you can create third-person interactive game experiences on Spline, like the one that you can see here. You can make your character move on the surface of the different scenes. You can create racing game experiences or walking game experiences, and even fly game experiences. And in this tutorial we will see how we can make this experience here on this little pig here moving over the surface of this island. So yeah, this is gonna be really fun. All right, so let's begin. All right, so for my scene, I'm going to use this island. So this island is available on the Spline library, so you can use it as well. And for the character, I'm using this little pig in here, which is very cute. And what I want is that I want the pig to, you know, to move around the island freely. The first step is to select the pig and then go to events and then create a new event. Then you can click on here, and then what we want is that we want to switch from the start event to the game controls event, which is the new one. Essentially, that's all you need to do to manipulate your character. And if I go to the play mode now, you can see that if I press the letter W, it is already working. Something is a little strange, which is that the character is kind of flip in the wrong direction. So what I can do now is that I'm going to exit the play mode, and then what I want is that I want to select all of the objects inside the container, and I want to just rotate everything by 190 degrees basically. So now it's pointing towards the front, and now if I play a game, you can see that now it makes more sense, right? Now I can move my character and I can actually go and explore things. So one thing that you should keep in mind is that by default, the game control is going to try to use whatever camera you have here apted, or the camera that you have here in the play settings. But you can also change that. You can create your own camera, and the camera, then you can assign it in here, in which is called the camera follow. You can see that right now it is using the personal camera because that's the only one that I have. Another thing that you should keep in mind is that when you enter in the play mode, the game control is going to retain the position of your camera as it is. So for example, if I zoom out like this and I go to the play mode, it's going to maintain that position. So it's, in this case, it looks a little far away, right? All right, so I'm going to exit the play mode now. And another thing that I want to show you is that if you go to the character very close here, you can see that there is this yellow rings in here. And those rings are actually what is called the collider. So if I click here again on the game controls, there is this panel that is called collision. And if I disable this, you won't see this. But this is very important because the collision, and in this case, this capsule, which is the collider, is what enables you to move the character on the surface, right? So it's going to collide with all of these other objects in your scene. So you can actually make this bigger if you want to. Like for example, if you make something like this and maybe you move the character like this, then it's gonna be floating a little bit, right? So when I move, you can see that it's like floating. So obviously, in this case, it doesn't make sense to do something like this, but you might have like a different idea for your scene, and maybe this is something that you need, right? So by default, when you create the game control, the capsule in this case tries to adapt to the size of the bounding box in your object. So let me just undo this. All right, so another thing to keep in mind is that if you press the letter S, you can center your camera in the object, and then you can try to easily position your camera in a way that feels good for your game. So now if I go here to the play mode, I think this is like a good position. Now you can see here that when I press the arrows, I can rotate these camera, so I can see the front in this case of the little pig in here. So this is very cool. So you can use your arrows to rotate left and right, but you can also go up and down, and you can see different point of views this way. So this is something that you can actually control. Everything about how the character moves is a combination of the movement panel and also the desktop and touch controls. So the desktop controls is what we are doing right now. Right now we are in a desktop, so we can interact using the keys. But we can also change the mode here. Like for example, maybe we can use the mouse instead for the rotation. So in that case, if I go to the play mode, I can just click and drag to rotate. Or I can have both, right? So both means that I can both clip and rotate, or I can rotate with the arrows. And obviously this is not affecting at all the movement of the character. All right, so what else we can do here? So each of these letters is assigned to an action. So if you click on the letter, for example, you can see that there is this letter W is assigned to the move forward behavior here. So if you click here, you can actually change the behavior of the letters. And the same for the ones in the arrows, they're assigned to rotation, but you can play around and assign different things. Like for example, maybe what I want here is to rotate right, and in here I also want to rotate, but in this case will be left. And if I play here and I click on D and A, I'm actually rotating. So now my experience is a little different because I'm rotating the camera while I am moving in this case, so it feels like more like a racing game or something like that. But it's actually quite nice, right? So let's go back there and let's just reset by pressing this button here, and let's just select here keys. We are like by default. Now, by default, this is on walking or walk mode, but you can also switch to fly mode, and just for fun, let's see how that works, right? So if I click here on fly and then I go to the play mode, what is going to happen is that now this character doesn't really have gravity. So you can see that now I'm actually flying, but I still collide with objects. So you can see that I can collide with objects. But if I move and rotate, you can see that I can go up and I can fly and do all sort of crazy things like woohoo. So I am a flying pig right now. Maybe if you're making a game experience with an airplane, you can actually simulate the flying this way. Or maybe you just want to navigate your scene as it is right now. All right, so let's go back to again to our normal mode here in walking, and let's see what these values here are. So by default, everything is on auto orientation, but if we disable these and we go to the play mode, you can see that what happens is that the character now, when I move to the size, is not orienting itself to the direction of the movement. So that's all that it is. So let's just go back to this one here. You can also change the speed. So if I increase this to something like this, and if I move, you can see it's a lot faster. So I can actually go, woo, I can go crazy. So that's too much, right? So let's just put it back to 1000. And the same with the rotation speed, it could be a lot faster. And we can also control the delay or the acceleration at the beginning, at the end. So this S and this E here means start and end. And the same for the rotation. So maybe for example, I want like a longer delay at the end. So if I move now, and you can see when I stop, kind of have like this little nice movement at the end because it keeps moving after the main action is done, right? So that's an interesting effect there. So let's just put it on 0.3 again. Here at the bottom, we have the gravity and the jump, right? So by default, if you press the space bar, you can jump. So the speed of the jump and the speed of the fall is based on a combination of gravity and jumping here. So if I reduce the gravity to something like -5 and I jump, I will go higher because now I have less gravity, right? So I can use a very little gravity, and I can also use maybe less jump, and that will slow down the jump. So it will be a little slower and also maybe not so intense. Another parameter that we can explore is the reset Y position. So this position indicates the distance at which the parameter is going to reset if you reach certain points. So in some games, when you fall, the experience is reset to avoid, like, you know, falling to the infinity, right? So in this case, that number is 3000. But let's say, for example, if I put this number like 300 instead, and then I play, when I reach here, I guess the level of the water is going to just reset, right? This makes a lot more sense in a different type of game experience, maybe in some sort of platformer in which you have like a hole or something. But yeah, just to illustrate the concept, this is how it works. We can also control the camera follow. By default, camera follow is orienting towards the direction of the cutter. So if I move this way, the camera is kind of like rotating slightly. So this is, you know, very useful because you don't need to worry about manually rotating the camera. But you can also disable this feature. And by default, if we put it on normal, then you can see that now I'm moving, but the camera is not really rotating. It's just only like panning in this case, right? So if we get back again to here, let's put it on angle again. We can also change the position delay. So if I put here, like, say 2 seconds, it's gonna take a little bit for the camera to adjust to the final position of the character. So you can see there, once I end up, once the character ends the movement, the camera is still moving a little bit like that. So that's a very interesting effect there. And again, you can do the same with the rotation delay there as well. And we can also constrain the rotation itself. Like right now, by default, it's already constrained by 90 degrees. You can change that. And if you're using normal, you can actually constrain both up and down and left and right. So you can have a lot of different effects just by adjusting these values in there. All right, so I think we went over the main things here in the game controls. So let's just play our experience right now, right? So we can press space to jump, we can navigate, we can rotate manually, or we can just rotate with the mouse. I want to show you a few other use cases of these, just for you to have an idea of how you can use the game controls in a different context. All right, so I have here this other scene. This is a lot more complex. There is a lot of objects in here, so it's definitely a lot of visual complexity. And the main character is this one in here. So this is a girl on a Vespa. And this experience is really nice because, well, first of all, this is using a custom camera, so I don't need to worry about the position of this camera that I have right now, because I know that when I go to a play mode, it's going to be using just this one. So if I go to a play mode now, and one interesting fact about this is that as soon as I start interacting with this scene, there will be sound, right? So we have a sound on the background. And we also have a sound for the motorbike. So you can see I can move here, and there's this really nice kind of like leaning effect on the motorbike. And I can also press the space bar to jump, and there is a sound attached to the jump as well. So you can build experiences like that very easily. In this case, what I'm doing for the girl and the Vespa here is that I have some key events assigned to the letters as well. So when she is, you know, moving, she will be leaning a little bit. So I can show you here, I have a container inside the game controls. And in this one, I had different steps. Like this is for jumping, and this is for like leaning. You can see that it's just a little bit lean to the size. And then what I do is I have this key down and key up event. So when I press D, it's going to lean a little bit to this side. And if I press to the other side, it will be like this. And then in key up, we just reset back to the base state. So it's a very simple setup here that in combination with the game controls, it plays and really well. Right, and for the sound, I have some empty objects here or groups, and then I have the sound. This is for the background, so I have two different sounds for the background, one for the music and one for birds and nature sounds. And for the motorbike, I have different sounds for when you're pressing the letter W, I want it to move forward, so there is a sound for that, and then there is a sound of a jump, and then there is like different conditions to stop the sound when you're moving. All right, so let's see another example. All right, so I have this other scene in here. This is like some sort of isometric type of game experience, right? And in this case, the game control is on one of these barrels, right? And then if I play here, so you can see that I'm moving the barrel. And there is a camera follow. You can see the camera is following. And something interesting happened when I rotate. So yeah, this is an interesting game experience here. So if you want to do something like this. This experience is also a good example of what happens if you fall in this case here, right? So if I fall here, it's gonna move down up to a certain point, and then it's just going to reset. So that point there is the reset Y position that I was mentioning before. So right now this is on -3000, but we could potentially put there like, let's say, 30,000. So that means that when I fall, it's going to spend a long time, and then it's going to reset. Yeah, finally, I just wanted to show you this scene. There is nothing different in here from the other scenes. I just think that this is pretty cool. So yeah, this is just like some sort of Western type of scene, and you can see how the pig is moving. So in this case, it's jumping actually quite high, so you can do that as well. But one thing that I want to show you actually here is that, so there is something very cool about what happens when you duplicate the game control. So for example, if I duplicate this pig here, and I put another one there, and then I duplicate it again, and maybe put it there, and then a game. Now if I go to the play mode, what is happening is that now I have control over all these characters, but because they collide differently, so you might have like some interesting experience there, which, you know, a bunch of characters. But you can actually assign different speeds to them. Like for example, maybe I want this to be more fast, so I can increase the speed. So it's gonna move like this, and maybe this is gonna be very, very slow, something like this. And then when I play, you can see this is very slow and the other one is really fast. Just make sure that you reassign your camera to the one that you want to use. So in this case, it's personal camera again. All right, so I hope you like this tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye bye.